Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of NetBeans, that is version 21, on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily run a simple Java program within our NetBeans IDE. So by the end of the video, you'll have a pretty much good idea about how to start writing Java projects within our NetBeans IDE. So I can guarantee you that after the end of the video, you'll be able to start solving your Java assignments that probably you have got from your school or college within our NetBeans IDE. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues during the installation, you can always mention on our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install NetBeans IDE, first thing that you need to have is Java. So for that I have already made a little video, so you need to just simply search over here JDK download and hit enter, and you'll be seeing this Java download. So you need to go to the official site of oracle.com and you'll be seeing Java downloads. So here you need to download either JDK 21 or JDK 17. It totally depends upon your choice. So you need to have at least one version of JDK installed on your system. So once you are done installing your JDK, it's time to install our NetBeans. So for that, I have to open a new tab and to just simply search over here NetBeans download and hit enter. And immediately you'll be seeing this Apache NetBeans releases link as a first search result. So you need to click on this link and it's going to redirect to the official site of Apache NetBeans. So this link, Apache NetBeans .org, this link I'm going to provide right in our description, so you can directly use that link to land over to the official site of Apache NetBeans. And once you are here, you'll be able to see something like Apache NetBeans and then the released version. So at the time of making of the video, the latest NetBeans version is 21. Alright, so maybe when you'll be watching the video, you might see some different version. It could be 22, 23, 24, whatever, right? So whatever steps I am showing on this video, so that steps will be pretty much same. That's a guarantee from my side. But if I see something which is like majorly changed, then I'm surely going to make another video. So you don't need to worry on that. Alright, for now you can totally, trust and watch this video till the end. So once you are here, what you need to do is you need to click on this download button and it's going to show you this downloading Apache NetBeans 21. Screen. So here you can see that it is available for Linux, for Windows and all these different operating system. So I'm going to show you it for Windows. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this one under installation and packages, the first one. All right so once you click on that, it's going to redirect to Apache Foundation page, you can see. And once you are here, you need to click on this link under HTTP and immediately you'll be able to see that our file is at least started downloading, right? I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll also minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and you can see that our latest version of Apache NetBeans version 21 is already been downloaded over here. And if you see the file size, it is 476 MB. All right so that's the first step that you need to do to download the software. Once you download, you need to just simply double click on the installer. So it will ask you for administrative privileges first. Click on yes and there you go. You can see our Apache NetBeans IDE is started configuring. Right, so our configuration is also done. So welcome to Apache NetBeans IDE 21. So let's first minimize our download directory so we can have a better visibility now. So you can see that our total installation size is 944 MB. And we also have a customize option and you can see that it's going to install our base IDE first, then you can use our NetBeans IDE for Java EC, Java E, then HTML5 or JavaScript, PHP. So for all these different languages, you can use our Apache NetBeans IDE 21. Alright, so from this list, I'm going to show you about Java. So don't worry, at the end of the video, you'll be able to know how you can run Java code within NetBeans. So for now, you need to click on next over here. So this is our license agreement. You can always read this. You need to accept the license agreement and then you need to click on next. And once you are here, you can see that it is properly recognized our Java program files, then Java, then the JDK path. Alright, so that's why I was telling at the beginning of the video that it is very important to have Java installed. So if you probably install Java 17, then it would have showed JDK-17 over here. Or if you are using, you know, the latest version of Java, which is 21, it should be showing this one. All right. So yeah, that about the JDK part. And here you can see that within program files, it's going to create a NetBeans 21 folder, and within that folder, it's going to save our file. All right. So everything is fine now. Just simply click on next. So it's, you know, ready to be installed. Click on install, and there you go. You can see our installation is ready to begin. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to let it finish installing it on our system. So once we are done, we'll be going back to this video. So we'll come back, and you can see that our setup is complete. So our installation is completed successfully. Our desktop shortcut for the Apache NetBeans IDE is also been created over here. So now everything is working as per expectation. So you know, to first simply click on finish, and then to double click on the shortcut on desktop to launch our Apache NetBeans. So you can see it is rightly started launching, and you can see that our Apache NetBeans IDE is rightly launched over here. So you can, you know, always, you know, click on all these links to learn more about NetBeans IDE. But don't worry, I'll be showing you all the things on this video itself. So first you need to go to file, and you need to click on this new project. So that will open this new project. So here you need to click on this Java with and. Alright, so you are going to create a Java application. So I am going to select Java with and, and then under projects I am going to select Java application, and then just simply click on next. So what will happen is it will ask you this name and project location. It will ask you the project name. So let's give the project name something like hello all. Alright, and you can see that our project location is rightly set, and our project folder is also rightly set. So everything is, you know, fine. You can see it also going to create hello all as our, you know, package name, and then hello all as our class name. So always remember, a class name is that the first initial are always to make capital. So that's what it means by class, right? Everything is fine. Just simply click on finish, and it's going to start creating our project. And you can see that our hello all project is rightly open. So if we expand all these, you'll be able to see that our hello all is our package, and then our hello all.java is our class file. So that file is also been opened over here. You can see the entire code over here. So we have a public class hello all, and then we have our main method. So here, if you just simply hit enter and type like something like system.out.println, and within bracket if you give something like hello world, right, and if you end with a semicolon. So if you just, you know, simply write this much, and then if you click on this run button, immediately you'll be able to see that it is rightly started building our project. And once it gets successfully built, you'll be able to see the output hello world rightly shown on our console, right? So in this way, you can easily create a project like hello world. You can create n number of projects within under projects, and then you can, you know, start working on all the assignments that you have got from your school or college. So if you need to create more class, you can always click on the package, then right click and hover over new, and you can create a Java class, and you can, you know, create n number of class over here. So let's say you want to create a new class, click on finish, and you can see another like hello all.java, another new class is also been created over here, right? And you can start writing your code over here. So in this way, you can install latest version of NetBeans IDE on a Windows operating system. After that, I have also showed you how you can easily create your project and how to run that within our NetBeans IDE. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.